Welcome. Let's begin with one of the very important theories in Origin of Town that was given by Henri Pirenne. Now, he was an historian from Belgium, and his idea about the theory or the origin of towns was basically the historical perspective. And he explained how the Italian towns, how the Russian towns expanded, and had a vivid discussion on the detailing of these towns, how the cities rose and fall. So this concept given by Henri Pirenne is very, very important. His ideas have been cited a lot with the works of Origin of Theory, Origin of Towns. So here are some of his works that are given. Now, one of the ways could be a direct question from which of these works is part of Henri Pirenne. So you must have an idea about the works that had been done by Henri Pirenne. Now let's have an understanding about his contribution. So he gave a concept which is known as Pirenne thesis. Under the Pirenne thesis, he explained how the Roman civilization maintained a continuity despite the fall of Rome, and that was because during that time Europe was witnessing a change in the rise of Islam that was seen, and it was not just the invasions that was part of the European system. So this whole thing was explained in this article, The Stages in the Social History of Capitalism, written in 1914, and based on this thesis was given, and this thesis formed the basis for many further works which believe that culture, religion, politics played a very important role in establishment of a town or a city. One of his works, The Medieval City, Their Origin and Revival of Trade, which came in 1927, was based on the lectures that he delivered in United States in 1922. Based on his lectures, he believed that during the 10th to 12th century, there was a period that was very, very important. Initially, what happened was Europe was flourishing. You had numerous towns and cities that was part of the European system. During the 7th century, with the Arab conflicts that came in, what happened was the urbanization ceased and you had the economy's ruralization that started. Once this ruralization started, you had the concept of closed estate economy that started to work around. His idea of merchant enterprise school was opposed to Marxism, but had few ideas in common about the merchant class. So Pirenne basically talked about a commercial renaissance that occurred in the various towns. So when he was explaining the decline, he said during the 7th century, there was a conflict that was basically the Arab conflict that led to decline of the European civilization, led to closed estate economy. In these closed estate economy, what happened was there was a landlord with nearly 10,000 acres of land, and you had lots of peasants that were working. All the produce that was grown was meant for them itself, and it was nothing was going out of the market. So everything that was produced was to be consumed within the region. However, during the 11th century, there happened crusades, and because of these crusades, Arabs were pushed back to the Near East. As a result, the trades, the city in the Europe revived again. There was a decline in the feudal system that was seen, and this was the basic idea that Pirenne talked about, and he talked about a kind of irreconcilable opposition that existed between the trade and the urbanization as well as feudalism. So that was one of his very important paramount concept that was there. The second important idea was the centrality of the sea, and the sea that was focused was Mediterranean Sea. Now this Mediterranean Sea was a center because you had multiple civilizations that grew around it. So you had the Roman civilization, you had the Greek civilization, you had the Egyptian civilization, the European civilization, and all these civilizations were trying to intersect one another, and this was a very, very fundamental transformation that was there. So the Mediterranean world did not had a kind of distinctive region, but it had a kind of multiple intersection of the civilizations that was seen. What Pirenne believed a city was, According to him, city was simply an economic entity which was based on a long distance trade. So according to him, long distance trade was a paramount condition for a city to survive and thrive well. He also said that these cities were basically the centers of capitalism in this feudal world, and according to him, the city's prosperity can be determined by the self-defeating industrial protectionism that's there. So that was his sole idea. Also, he believed that this feudal crisis would lead to decline in the rural production, low yield, low quantum of production that is there, and the extent of the arable land was also affected because of this feudal system. So this internal crisis needs to be ruled out, and with the growth of the towns and the cities, the growth of the trade, you would have the revival of the towns and the cities that would take place. So his whole idea of the rise and the fall of the feudal system in Europe was in line with the rise and the fall of the trade in Europe. So I repeat in summary again, the idea was in the till the 7th century, very good trade, very flourishing cities in Europe. But with the 7th century, you had advent of Arab conflict that came in. You had a closed East State economy that started. This closed East State economy pushed up the feudal behavior. However, during the 11th century, you again had crusades and the Arabs were shifted to Near East. As a result, the trade and the cities revived further. So that was the concept given by Henri Pirenne. And he believed that this disruption was one of the basic causes for the rise and the fall of the European nations. And this led to decline of the feudalism later on. However, the same was replicated in Indian scenario, where R.S. Sharma basically tried to explain the Indian historical landscape, and he said that with the fall of Gupta Empire in India, the urbanization declined. You had a rural, economic ruralization that started, and at that time there were no coins that were available. So anything that was to be granted was through the Brahmins or through the most sacred persons, most revered person of the region, and this brought about a class distinction. So you had class stratification, class distinction that started up, and again the Aghara in Indian system were considered equivalent to manor in the European feudal system. So that was the kind of writings that were brought about. The status of caste was brought about. So that's how Henri Pirenne's concept was brought about in the Indian scenario. So that's again very, very important. So Henri Pirenne, a historian by perspective, but his ideas about revival of town made it important to become a part of the geographical understanding why certain things occurred at certain places. So those are some of the major aspects that we have discussed about him. We'll be continuing with many new topics, the many new additions in the syllabus. Stay tuned. Have a wonderful day ahead.